God has blessed man with many bounties, with many magical attractions. But due to our own negligence, ignorance and carelessness, the beauty of nature is diminishing day by day. Various sources are playing a crucial part in distortion of our rivers, oceans, and in general, the whole environment. There are many factors which are contributing in the environmental degradation, and the leather industry is one of them. Leather is one of the major exports of Pakistan and is considered an important source of foreign exchange for the country. There are about 600 tanneries working in Pakistan, out of which a cluster of 200 tanneries is located in Sector 7A of the Kurangi Industrial Area. Nowadays, WTO demands for the compliance of environmental laws and standards for the production of leather. Therefore, it would be necessary to take this international trend seriously to sustain and enhance the market of leather products in international markets. The pollution generated by the tanning sector is of three types, which include wastewater, solid waste, and air emissions. However, wastewater generated from tanneries is highly polluted as compared to others. The contamination level in wastewater is very high, as compared to the set limits of national environmental quality standards. The waste generated from the industries of Kurangi Industrial Area is directly discharged to sea without any treatment. This is creating a negative impact on the marine environment of the country. Pakistan Tanners Association Environmental Society, realizing the importance of this issue, initiated a comprehensive environmental management program in 1994. The program comprised of two major components, that is, construction of combined effluent treatment plant and implementation of cleaner technologies. As the first phase of the program, the major part of combined effluent treatment plant has been completed at a cost of 500 million rupees, and it is foreseen that the plant would be functional soon. This project would be the first of its kind in the private sector for pollution control in Pakistan. The second component is the implementation of cleaner technology program. This program is aimed to solve the environmental problems of the Kurangi tanneries through technically simple and cost-effective technologies. The scope of program includes environmental audit, implementation of cleaner technologies, assistance in self-monitoring and reporting required by law, and implementation of solid waste management program in individual tanneries and at cluster level. Environmental management system. Trainings to the tannery workers and management staff would also be provided under this project. The main objective of this project is to enable the Kurangi tanneries to comply with the national environmental quality standards and certification of environmental management system. Cleaner production options are technically simple and cost effective, which are considered facilitating for pollution abatement. Cleaner production options in tanneries include proper raw trimming, salt de-dusting, green flushing, hair saving, lime cycling, deliming with carbon dioxide gas, pickle recycling, chrome recovery and reuse, establishment of laboratory, energy conservation, use of environment friendly chemicals, and water conservation. Proper raw trimming. In the first step of tanning process, skins and hides are transported to tanneries. These are trimmed to remove the excessive parts to give the skins a proper shape. If skins and hides are trimmed properly, then excessive weight can be reduced. As a result of this, the amount of chemicals used in production would be curtailed. Salt de-dusting. Salt is applied on skins and hides to preserve them from any damage due to bacterial contamination. Removing this salt before soaking process would reduce the consumption of water for washing and the chemicals used in soaking and the liming processes. Also, the effluent of these processes will have lesser quantity of chemicals and salt, which would help to minimize the adverse impact on the environment. Adopting this mechanism would also reduce the duration of soaking and liming processes. Above all, the leather produced would be of better quality. Green fleshing. Usually, fleshing is carried out after the liming process in tanneries. If the tanneries adopt fleshing process before liming, many benefits can be achieved. For example, the flesh and fats obtained as a result would be chemical free. Therefore, its better utilization would be possible, and they could be used in chicken feed and gelatin. Besides this, consumption of chemicals would be minimized in the next steps of tanning processes. As a result, better quality of leather would be produced due to better penetration of chemicals in the skins. Hair saving. Hairs which are on the surface of the skins can be separated before liming process, and as a result, quantity of sulfide required in liming process would be reduced. By adopting this procedure, various other benefits can also be achieved. For example, the duration required for liming process would be minimized, and consumption of chemicals in other processes would be reduced. Besides this, the quantity of sludge generated by this process would be reduced, and above all, the quality of leather would be improved due to better penetration of chemicals in the skins. Lime recycling. The discharged effluent from the liming process can be reused after separating the insoluble solid particles from the lime float. The separation of insoluble solid can be done by passing the discharge float through the filtration plant. Usually, 30% quantity of sodium sulfide and lime is present in the lime discharge. Water, lime, and sodium sulfide can be saved this way. Deliming with carbon dioxide. The deliming process is carried out after liming process to separate the lime and sodium sulfate from skins. This process is aimed to save the skins from the adverse impacts of chemicals. In Pakistan, ammonium sulfate is used for the deliming process. Carbon dioxide gas is used for the deliming in developed countries. This technology is economically beneficial and environmental friendly as well. Pickle recycling. The process of pickling is carried out after the deliming process, which is aimed to gradually reduce the higher pH. This process helps to prepare the skins for the other processes of tanning. 80% of salt and 25% of acid is present in discharge from this process, which can be reused by adding the remaining 20% salt and 75% acids. Adoption of this recommendation is not only cost effective but also environment friendly. Besides this, consumption of chemicals would also be saved. Chrome recovery and reuse. The chrome used in the tanning process can be recovered through chrome recovery plant and it can be reused. It has been proved by experiments that reuse of recovered chrome does not have any adverse impact on the quality of leather. The payback period of cost spent on chrome recovery plant is few months. Establishment of laboratory. It is advisable for leather processing units to establish a laboratory as it helps in maintaining the quality of leather and its products. A laboratory can be set up by spending a small amount. A lot of benefits can be achieved through it, as all the purchased chemicals can be tested and the performance of leather processes can also be analyzed. Besides this, the discharge float can be tested for reuse and the quantity of chemicals in the discharged effluent from the tannery can also be measured. Energy conservation. It is observed that a huge amount is spent on electricity in leather processing units. Few recommendations can be adopted to minimize the cost of electricity. For example, if proper maintenance is done for all electric machineries, wires used as per the required electric load, and maintenance record is kept properly. Besides this, cleaning of machines, switching off those machines which are not in use and switching off unnecessary lights can also help to conserve energy and cut costs as well. Use of environment-friendly chemicals. Various types of chemicals are used for leather processing. It is recommended that enzymes and biodegradable surfactants should be used. This will not only avoid the adverse impact of chemicals on the workers' health, but would also help to save the environment. water conservation. A huge quantity of water is required for leather processing, and most of the tanneries fill their need by purchasing water tankers. Therefore, a huge amount is spent in this regard. By adopting few recommendations, the quantity of water used by the industry can be saved. For example, installation of flow meters can be helpful in this regard, as the required quantity of water would be utilized. Batch washing should be adopted instead of continuous washing. Only those processing recipes should be used in which consumption of chemicals and water is minimum. For flow washing, pipes of small diameter and wipers should be used. Leakages in pipes and taps should also be repaired, as it would help reduce the wastage of water. If it is stated that implementation of cleaner technologies is in our own favor, it would not be wrong, because these measures are not only helpful to save the production cost, but these measures would also help to boost the leather exports. Do we want to see a brighter future or a dark one? The decision is in our hands.